bride. It's so wild that this day has finally come. It's been 7 long years of waiting, and I'm so happy that we are continuing this journey at the same place it started. You really have always been my rock. You've seen all my successes and failures and loved me through it all. You have made me into a better man, and I can't wait to see where life takes us. Today is the first step into the adventure that is the rest of our lives together. It still blows my mind that I get to call you my wife and you get my last name. I promise to be the best husband I can be and love you unconditionally through it all. You're my princess and always will be. Love your husband.
G, the day we've dreamed of since we were 14. As I sit here and write these words, I'm thanking God for the way He intertwined our paths and so intricately wove our stories together. From this day forward, I vow to love and to cherish every part of you, to put Christ at the center of our marriage, and to be faithfully devoted to you. I vow to always be on your team and to come alongside you in pursuit of your dreams, to sleep in with you on the weekends, and to always watch reruns of Ted Lasso. For as long as we live, G, I'll follow you to wherever you're called. You're the love of my life and my best friend and my strongest teammate. And on this day, we get to begin our lives beside one another and take on each day together. We're stronger together, and I can't wait to see what our future holds. I love you so much, Annie.
We are gathered here today in the presence of God, both to witness and to bless the joining together to this man and this woman as husband and wife. What will take place here today is not man's idea, but it is God's. I mentioned earlier that a miracle would take place today, that in God's hand, two persons joined together in marriage equal a fuller, richer one. Individually, you're both absolutely incredible, but together, you have even greater potential. On one hand, there's potential for joy, intimacy, beauty, and encouragement, and on the other hand, there's potential for pain, brokenness, sorrow, and heartache. This is your marriage, and you have a huge say in how life-giving it's going to be. So as you both enter into this exciting new season today, I first want to encourage you to focus on your faith. It has to start here. You were both created for abundant life. You were created to discover and grow into the versions of yourselves that God created you both to be. So as you continue to navigate this broken world, do not become distracted and do not lose sight of the fact that abundant life comes only from Jesus. Gavin, Annie, your love is powerful. You are each other's people, and every single day you get to play a part in the sanctification of one another. You are better together. You always have been, and you always will be. Don't ever stop pursuing one another, and don't ever let your love grow stagnant. So focus on your faith, focus on one another, and lastly, friends, focus on the greater cause. Friends, this marriage is not just a gift for you to enjoy, but it is also to be shared. The world needs what you will become, what you are already becoming. Your love in your marriage is to be a light into the darkness and the brokenness that plagues this world. Gavin, Annie, have fun, laugh a lot, and don't take yourselves too seriously, but take very seriously this gift, which you've been given here today. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I now declare that Gavin and Annie are husband and wife. Gavin, you may kiss your bride. Friends, it is with great pleasure that I now have the opportunity to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Gavin McGahee!